I think Europe is at the forefront, but are we actually meeting planetary needs of our future generations? No, we need to speed up.
Hello, you're watching The Big Question, the series from Euronews where we speak to leaders in business about some of the most pressing issues on today's agenda. I'm Angela Barnes, and today I'm joined by Marta Sjögren, the co-founder and co-CEO of Pebble, a Nordic Dutch company storing CO2 in construction material. First of all, can you just give us a little bit more context about what Pebble does?
We take CO2, the gas, the carbon dioxide, and quite simply turn it into CO3. So it's a solid state carbonate, and thereby we lock away CO2 permanently. So we mimic a natural process whereby in nature, every day since the beginning of times and forever, CO2 that's in the air doesn't actually want to be in the air, and it will get pulled down by rain, by water, and it will merge with magnesium silicates or calcium silicates, and it will form a carbonate rock. All we do is that we industrially speed that up by about 10 million times. And therefore, in an industrial reactor, you can just generate the same reaction in minutes.
What other materials can be made with Pebble's technology?
What we have experimented with are bioplastics, regular plastics, paper, and then, of course, concrete. And as a company, because we want to restore the planetary carbon balance by quite a large amount by the year 2050, we focused on the most high priority sector, which is concrete. I mean, concrete is the most widely used material after water.
Concrete as well is often seen as one of the hardest sectors to decarbonize. Why is that?
Concrete is difficult to decarbonize because cement is difficult to decarbonize. Cement also, for various reasons, hasn't been really innovated on for quite a long time. But there's really been no incentives. Now there are incentives. There is the climate urgency, that's one thing. There's also the increasing costs of production of everything because of the supply chains that are getting more complicated. And finally, and not the least, we need to build more. So it's becoming more of an agenda item. Industrial resilience is as a whole.
I read on your website, Pebble's solution reduces the carbon footprint of concrete by 70%. What does that mean for the construction industry, for example, which accounts for 8% of global emissions? Yeah.
Well, firstly, technically we can reduce it up to that amount. Now it's up to the value chain to figure out how much of a material it allows to input into the concrete mix. So What's happening in Europe right now is that the European trading system of CO2 emissions, so the ETS, is opening up to cement being charged for the emissions that it produces. Because we replace some portion of cement, therefore those using our material can decrease the cost of material procurement, because we simply do not have a carbon tax, because we're a negative emissions technology. Whilst we're very, very small, like we are right now, of course our cost of production is higher than regular concrete ingredients. However, within the coming 5 years or less, we foresee that we will be quite price competitive. And that's because we're using CO2, which is usually a waste stream, and as an input in the mix.
What could this mean for the future of housing in Europe?
In Europe, if we are good at adopting technologies like ours, we will not only be environmentally more friendly, but because we're more economical in terms of the overall energy footprint, it should also get cheaper.
And Marta, the EU is often seen as a leader in sustainability. Do you think the pace of change here is fast enough in Europe, or are we still lagging, would you say, when it comes to large-scale industrial decarbonisation?
I think that lagging is a question of lagging behind whom? I think
US, China?
No, I think Europe is at the forefront, but are we actually meeting planetary needs of our future generations? No, we need to speed up. I can't comment about other parts of the world, other than I think China is doing some interesting things. I think Europe is ahead and US is very quickly falling behind. It's very unfortunate to see.
You touched on the US seems to be rolling back on its carbon capture programs. How do you see this divergence shaping the future of global decarbonization efforts?
It's very difficult to tell what is going to happen. I mean, every day we wake up to some kind of news that we don't know what to do with. What we do know is that, you know, talent is central to any economy. And more than ever before, we have talent from amazing backgrounds in the US reaching out to us because they're worried about whether it's about scientific integrity or economically rational decisions. They're worried about rational decision-making in the US. And here in Europe, we seem to be quite stable. And so I think that there's gonna be a huge influx of talent that just wants to deliver on their career targets and their planetary ambitions, frankly.
So Marta, with the EU Clean Industrial Deal targeting a 90% emissions reduction by 2040, how do you see the role of private companies, like Pebble, of course, in helping meet these very ambitious targets?
I believe that private companies will be at the very center of this, leading the way in terms of creating a blueprint for how you can use the built environment as a sustainability solution and also save money. But let's not forget, most concrete today is used by public spaces. So hopefully the public projects that are going to be built in the coming decade or slightly more than a decade will learn quickly from the private sector and also therefore enable the larger scale up of these technologies.
How does Pebble's technology contribute to the overall European vision of transforming the built environment into a massive carbon sink?
So that's a great question. So in Europe, we are very committed to resource efficiency. And the built environment, because it is such a huge source of emissions today, if you can flip that equation and if every single building can be storing a little bit of carbon as a carbon custodian, I think that goes a long way, both economically and environmentally. And if you think about the bigger picture here in Europe, we're, you know, quite built out, but the Global South is just in that process of building out infrastructure and building out cities. And so from Europe, we can be leading the way with adopting the technologies quickly and then also partnering with the Global South to actually scale these technologies beyond Europe.
Brilliant. Well, Marta, I wish you the very best of luck with scaling up, and thank you very much for joining us on The Big Question.
Thank you for having me.